In last week's video, we showed you how to create a custom collage effect and how to create a basic template out of it. While in this video, we are going in detail on how to create a custom Fusion template and how you can use it not only in the Fusion page, but as well in the edit page and how to customize it. Let's get started. As always, we want to thank everyone that joined our channel, and if you haven't subscribed already, think about doing so. Making Fusion templates is really handy. It can dramatically speed up your workflow. And there's actually a few different ways on how you can save your Fusion effects to reuse them later on. Let's jump into Fusion and see how to do it. I have here a little sequence that I prepared specially for today's tutorial so we can see how to apply a template from the effect library and how to customize it. Let's watch it first. Okay, first we're going to pick where we want to apply the effect. We're going to start on this clip, go to the FX library, and in FX, you'll find all the templates that have been prepared for the edit page. Drag the effect, drop it on the clip, go to the inspector, click on the FX icon, and here you'll find all the tools that have been saved in our template. You can customize the text and all the aspects of the line, color, and position. This template is a variant from the collage effect that we created together in previous video. And if you haven't watched already, here's a link so you can catch up and see how we did it. One neat feature for using Fusion effects in the edit page is the Fusion overlay. Click on the arrow next to the transform icon, choose Fusion overlay, and here you can see two controls that we created to manipulate our line, our text. Now let's see how you can do this with your own templates. I'm going to open a Fusion compositions that contain all the nodes that have been used in the templates. And we're going to see three techniques to save those nodes to reuse them later. First, and the simplest, you can export actually all the composition and re-import it in any project. To do this, while in Fusion, go to File, Export, Fusion Composition, save it wherever you like for backup. I'm going to delete this. And to import your nodes in a different project, go to File, Import, Fusion Composition, double click, and here you have all the nodes that have been added. The second technique will be to save the nodes as settings. For this, select the nodes. You don't need to add the media out because it will be automatically added in any Fusion clip that you're gonna create. Right click, Settings, Save As. And because of restrictions, you won't be able to directly save to the program file folder. Save it to desktop, for example, and in the Explorer, copy your setting file, go to Program File, Blackmagic Design, DaVinci Resolve, Fusion Templates, Fusion, and paste your file, give the access, and after restarting Fusion, you will find your effect in the template library. Drag and drop, and here, you just need to connect the nodes together. And there you go, that's simple. The third technique is to use macros to create a template that you can customize and add in the edit page. For this, select the nodes that you want to save, right click, macro, create macro. This is going to open the macro editor in which you're going to select every single feature that you want accessible in the edit page. It is a little bit confusing at first because there's a lot of parameters to choose from and you might not know exactly what they are. And you might need some trial and error to figure out which are actually the one that you want to keep. Don't worry though, because you can always edit your macro and choose which parameters is visible or not. And actually, I'm going to open the macro for the template that we created so you can see the options that we use. Okay, very important. For an effect that you want to use in the edit page, you need one input and one output at least. Our input is going to pass by this merge node. So select it, open it in macro editor, and make sure that background is checked. Same thing for the output, but this time make sure that output is selected. Now, for every each node that has features that you want to be able to modify inside the edit page, I recommend selecting it, opening it in the macro editor, and find the matching option for every each parameter. For example, if I'm looking for the font, I have it here, font, and as you can see, you can even customize the name of the parameter. With a bit of practice, you'll see that it's not very complicated to find the matching parameter. And for example, for a color effect, we chose not to use this color option. We went to shading and use this one. And to make sure that the text and the line share the same color, we use the same feature that we showed you in the previous video, where we went to the background and added expression for every channel that we linked to the one in the text shading. Then in the macro editor for your text, you can go to shading and find the matching options. For example, you can see that appearance is matching with the options right here. Color opacity, same. Go down and I can see the color. I selected color, green and blue, which are matching for the color picker and every channel. Sometimes you want to be able to change the value of multiple parameters with one custom controller. For this, and as we did in the callout controller, we created one for line positions. When we drag this around, we're changing the position of this line. To create your own custom controller, right click on the nodes that you want to attach your controller to, go to edit control, give it a name. For ID, choose new control. Choose the type of data that's going to contain. For page, choose in which page it's going to appear, which is corresponding to the one in the inspector. In that case, we're going to choose control. Select a type of input. I'm going to take a slider. Put the range from 0 to 1. Again, it's just an example. View control, none. And type OK. And here, automatically it's been added in the inspector. For now it's not connected to anything, but you could create an expression to control anything with this slider. This is very powerful, and you can create your own custom interface and have any kind of control that you want. Now that you made your selection and maybe even created your own custom control, it's time to save your macro as a template. Go to File, choose Save As, go back to Fusion, select Templates, go to Edit, Effect, and here save your effect so it can appear in your effect library after restart. And after doing this, you'll be able to add and customize your Fusion effects from the edit page. And if you want to go even further, you can actually completely customize templates or even create your own features using the Lua programming language. This is way more advanced, but if this is something that you would be interested in, please let us know in the comment down below. So, if you enjoyed this video, leave a thumbs up, and don't forget to check out please about the VFX and DaVinci Resolve. And we'll see you in the next video. Peace!